for us somewhere, a place for us, peace and quiet and open air. Wait for us somewhere. There's a time for us, someday a time for us, time together and time to spare, time to learn, time to care. Someday, somewhere, we'll find a new way of living. We'll find a way of forgiving. There's a place for us, or time and space for us. Hold my hand and we're halfway there. Hold my hand and I'll take you there. Somehow, someday, there's a place for us, or time and space for us. Hold my hand and I'll take you there. Hold my hand and I'll take you there. Somehow, someday,
now I'd like to welcome our national audience joining us for this evening of gratitude. I'm Father Jack Wall, President of Catholic Extension, and tonight we're here to celebrate and to give thanks. That may sound like a strange thing to do in times like these, as we look back on a year of many losses. Loss of jobs, loss of health and well-being, loss of togetherness with our loved ones, and so much loss of life. And yet through it all, I assure you, our sense of hope remains strong, because signs of God's grace abound everywhere. Your partnership with Catholic Extension is truly a vehicle for God's grace to extend to the furthest reaches of our country, and especially to those communities struggling the most at this time. Allow me to introduce you to a few of the community leaders who have gratefully received your life-giving support this year, as well as some of the partners we work with that help ensure that even in these most difficult times, God's light is able to pierce the darkness in the poorest regions of America.
Sister Kathleen Atkinson from Annunciation Monastery, serving at Ministry on the Margins. Right here we have our food pantry, and every week hundreds of households come to get their needs met. But you know what this grant has helped us to do? It's helped us to do the emergency needs. a family who has tested COVID positive now can buy the cleaning equipment that they need. Someone can use the gas to get to the hospital. A car that is broken down got fixed. These are the emergency needs and the little miracles that have helped sustain us, and I want to say thank you. Thank you to the Catholic Extension Society and the supporters.
I want to take the opportunity to thank Father Jack, the staff, the Board of Governors, but in a very special way, I want to thank the donors to Catholic Extension, because they are the ones really that enable Father Jack and Catholic Extension and the board to be of service throughout the history of the diocese. Catholic Extension has helped us and enabled us to minister to God's people. And I want to say that we are limited in material resources, but not in terms of human resources. So the monies from Catholic Extension, from our donors, empowers our human resources to do ministry and to reach out. And particularly, I would say, with Hispanic ministry, we have a large and a growing Hispanic population in Southeast Texas. And though most of them are Catholics, they need to be catechized. They need to develop, there's a need to develop leadership, particularly in the parishes. The other big gift, I would say, to the diocese is, from Catholic Extension, is monies for our youth program, our diocesan youth program. And basically what that program does, of course, is to bring our young people together, but also to develop the lay leaders in the parish. Many of our parishes cannot afford to pay a youth minister. We were going through some dark times, and so Catholic Extension was that light to help us out. For instance, our retreat center took in 8 feet of water. Fortunately, we were able to restore it. So, and I talked to my fellow bishops from the Mission Diocese, and they feel the same way. There's so much, yes, we have the human resources, but we do not have the material resources. So through Catholic Extension, with the material resources, we're really able to unleash, if you will, and empower people to bring the light of Christ to others.
Aringshik Conchita Posar, Kashu Irekash, in Kumanchikimbo, Comunida in Gisaring, North Shore, California, Engadhi Diocesis San Bernardino, Anapum Pertenecerishin, Kahik Shesawakshin, Wanda Piratak Mahich, Junction, Catholic Extensionish, Eskatses Litamaquariak, in Yas, Engisun Wanhakaya. En Gaxisarik, Día de Acción de Gracias, Purein Poengisarik, Datariosik, Dios Mayemukin Shuntan, En Gaxes Nitamanaka, Iwashurin, Dios Mayemuke, Hixashu, Isarash Shu, Huche Kumanjikingun, Huche Nanak Sabichun Hingun, Huche Sashu, Tingu Quatsun, Datariosik, Dios Mayemukin Shuntan, Kurchar Nanawari, Dios Mayemukin Shuntan, En Ganucha, Iwashurin, Kahuria Tiuria Tibo, Ses Nitamanaka. Eskatzes nita makoriak jamit char kumanjikimbo katatario shikshinuk chakure chans jamit engat inden anjita kwanuk Catholic Extension. Dios mayemuke.
My name is Sue Geegan, and I'm the Director of Human Concerns at Holy Family Catholic Community in Inverness, Illinois. A few years ago, Holy Family was introduced to Catholic Extension by our pastor, Father Terry Keehan, and our relationship has grown and blossomed ever since. In 2014, I and three other Holy Family staff personnel participated in our first Catholic Extension immersion trip to the Hollers of Kentucky in the Appalachian Mountains. We listened to people tell their stories of struggles, courage, and the great faith they possessed which gave them strength to endure. Those stories were shared with our parishioners over 6 weeks of Lent that year. Since that time, our parish has been transformed multiple times because of these powerful real-life stories from people living in some of the poorest areas of the United States, Cuba, and Mexico. Over the past few years, I've had the honor to participate in many other immersion trips. I've laughed and I've cried with people as they share their unique stories of great faith in the midst of challenge. Those stories have deeply impacted me, our parish staff, and parishioners while reaffirming our commitment to social justice. During our trip to Kentucky, we were told, if you need help, you go to the Catholics. Catholic Extension is that bridge and path to empowerment, giving dignity and hope to many faith communities with limited resources. Catholic Extension gives people a voice that needs to be heard.
I hope that through these brief videos, you might taste and see the goodness of the Lord present and at work in these inspiring people we encounter in our mission dioceses and among our parish partners. And I hope that you experience this as well in the presence and inspiration of a man who was bishop of two Extension dioceses for many years before becoming chancellor of Catholic Extension 6 years ago. Please welcome Cardinal Blaise Supich, Archbishop of Chicago.
As a chancellor of Catholic Extension, I want to wish all of you a blessed Thanksgiving. We gather this evening to give thanks to God for the countless blessings we have received, even in this very difficult time, fraught with uncertainty, hardship, and pain. Your presence with us tonight and your concern for the mission of Catholic Extension are inspiring signs of hope. Through your generosity, the mission churches we support can reach out to the poor, the sick, and the weary. They surely have not been abandoned. So, my heart is full of gratitude not only for you, our donors, but also for the dedicated staff of Catholic Extension. For the past 115 years, you have been a great gift to the Church in the United States by building vibrant and transformative communities of faith. Catholic Extension continually brings our attention to the peripheries of our nation and to the peoples who are easily forgotten or overlooked. 22 years ago, when I became the bishop in Rapid City, South Dakota, Father Jack Wall and Catholic Extension were the first to step forward with support that allowed us to grow our ministry on 5 Native American reservations. It was then that I learned a Lakota phrase, Metakio Owasin, which is often used by an elder at the end of a speech. It simply means, we are all related, we are all relatives. It expresses an understanding of human existence as belonging to a people who share a common heritage and destiny. And in stark contrast to radical individualism, it reminds tribal members that they discover who they are, their purpose, and dignity through their relationships with one another. This wisdom holds true for all of us. In his recently released encyclical, Fratelli Tutti, destined to be a defining document in his body of teaching, Pope Francis calls upon all of humanity to act as one family. By engaging the global community at this critical moment in history, the Holy Father aims to spark a fresh way of living by reminding us that only through our relationships as brothers and sisters to one another do we gradually come to know ourselves. Today, as Chancellor of Catholic Extension, I see how Catholic Extension builds relationships, unity, and friendships in our country and church. It reaches across the dividing lines and boundaries that would otherwise separate us. In a very concrete way, our involvement with Catholic Extension puts into practice Pope Francis's vision of a humanity that dreams together and reminds us that we are all one people, one family in God. Friends, I thank you for being good Samaritans. That is to say, people who through your support of Catholic Extension recognize our common humanity and share destiny with diverse communities across geographic and socioeconomic boundaries who need our help. Thank you for building bridges at this moment in our history, when bridges of goodwill and friendship are so desperately needed. May God bless you and your families this Thanksgiving.
Thank you, Cardinal Supich. We're so grateful to you for your leadership and for your constant encouragement of our mission. And to you, our donors as well, I'm so grateful for all that you have done and all that your generous spirit means to the mission of Catholic Extension. One of the things that makes Catholic Extension such an effective means of transformation in our country is that we do not aimlessly chase disasters. But when disaster strikes, such as this pandemic, we are ready to help literally at a moment's notice. That's because we have walked in solidarity with the poorest communities in our country for the past 115 years. Their leaders know us, and we know them. Pope Francis has urged us not to allow threats to human life and dignity to remain abstract in our minds, measured only by numbers and statistics. Rather, he's asking us to measure them by stories, by faces, by families. And that is why I feel compelled tonight to ask you to help us make sure that the burden of this COVID-19 pandemic does not fall even harder on the poorest among us. Our Extension-supported faith communities are an incredible source of hope, of inspiration, and of aid and care to those that are suffering the most this year. Programs such as the Sisters on the Front Lines, which enables religious women to serve families in great need due to the pandemic, are impacting the lives of thousands. This includes people like Anna Maria in California. She's 80 years old and lost her job at the fruit packing plant and couldn't support her two grown sons, each of whom is disabled and completely dependent on her. Or people like Jose in Arkansas, who recently lost his vision in both eyes, was infected with COVID-19, admitted to the hospital, lost his job as a house cleaner, and is struggling to support his family. Or people like Rosita, living on the Navajo Reservation in Arizona, who is an excellent weaver, but due to the coronavirus, now has no income. And she lives in a remote location with no transportation or running water. In each case, a compassionate local faith community, led by a Catholic sister and supported by Catholic Extension, got these families help when their situation was most dire. That's because when the pandemic hit, these sisters saw suffering faces and suffering families, not abstract numbers and statistics. I am absolutely certain that one of the greatest ways that we can affect change is by investing in our faith communities in the poorest regions of our country. And this year, during this crisis, we see exactly why this is true. And so as I thank you tonight for being some of our most generous and loyal donors, I also come with a heartfelt request. As we have just witnessed, and witnessed over and over again, women religious are a profound blessing in our Extension dioceses. Would you be willing to give a special Christmas gift this year of $1,000 to help a sister replicate this life-saving work in another forgotten community? And we promise you this, with your special investment, her work of mercy will be carried out not in some distant future, but tangibly and immediately and lovingly. God bless you for being the special blessing you are to Catholic Extension. And as we come to the close of this evening, I'd like to ask Rod Dixon if he would give us one more song and a prayer to send us out renewed in our commitment and our mission to build faith, inspire hope, and ignite change. Good night, God bless you, and happy Thanksgiving. Be safe and be well.
Our eyes and watch us where we go. And help us to be wise in times when we don't know. Let this be our prayer when we lose our way. Lead us to a place, guide us with your grace, to a place where we'll be safe. Son, your wonder center, purvulenza, un mondo di giustizia e di speranza. Just like every child need to find a place, guide us with your grace, give us faith so we'll be safe. En la fede che hai accesso in noi, sento che ci salverà.